Gurung and me, my Alicia Bharti, and I'm studying counseling psychology in ICMS in Nepal. So the topic itself is that what are the tools and methods for community justice, as we have heard about flood, earthquake, so many group members talk about risks, but we talking about the tools and methods. So our presentation we have divided into two sections. A first section will be covered by me and the second section will be covered by Bhavna. So first topic is understanding risk. First of all, we have to understand the risk, and the second is effective way of communicating disaster. So I will be covering understanding risk. So understanding the risk. We are living in the world where there will be risk anytime and any possible situation. So we have to be ready for any kind of disaster, any kind of risk. So understanding what the risk. For example, the definition itself says that there is a probability and frequency of occurrence of a defined hazard and the magnitude of the consequences of occurrence. How often is a particular potentially harmful event going to occur? And what are the consequences of this occurrence? So I will tell you about one risk. As you all know, even China and Nepal are familiar with the earthquake. We know about the risk of, about the earthquake. For example, in Nepal, we didn't used to be serious about earthquake in any way. We used to feel that there were only a small magnitude of earthquake before the big magnitude of earthquake. There was like what, 2-3 Richter only, and we used to have fun like this is like sailing, okay, and it will stop. It was like that in the past. But there was a day it happened in Nepal that the 7.8 magnitude of earthquake happened, and now if we look back, the risk was really severe and the risk was really destructive to the Nepali society. So now we understand risk in different ways. For example, I'm only giving example of earthquake. You can relate to the flood, you can relate to the air pollution, you can relate to any kind of risk. There are risks everywhere and we have to prepare for that. And so there are different types of risk. Okay, first economic, and there is second technological, third societal, fourth geopolitical, and five environmental. Environmental, we can see clearly from our own eyes that like for example, in Chengdu, it's always raining, and the students from my class were saying that there were floods in their area. So environmental risk. And then geopolitical, my ma'am, Yu Fan Ji Chen from Coventry University, she's from Coventry University. She said that there is a Syria war, different kind of war, and then there is societal, technological. As you can see, we are in the world where there is most use of technology. Even in China, I saw people just their head down most of the time. If my professor talked about one topic, they will just automatically search in the mobile. So we are in the technological time. But there will be some advantages, but along with that, there will be disadvantages. For example, as you can see, they are wearing glasses. Most of the guys, I mean, even in my class, 1 in 10 people are wearing this glass. So there are risks with advantages. Automatically, there are disadvantages. This kind of risk is also there. So economic risk. So risk is everywhere. And there is another slide, risk perception and decision making. Okay, as I have already given you an example about the earthquake, our perception were really different about the earthquake. And now our perception has changed. And why there is a different perception? Because people are different. I'm different, my wife is different, our brother is different. So every people are different. So their belief, attitude, judgment, feeling, everything will be different. And even in the earthquake also, some people felt so anxious. They were in the third building, they were so anxious. Some people jumped down the building and they were they were very hot. But some people did not. Down the building and they were protecting others. So people's feelings, judgment, judging about the situation is very different, and with that they will make a decision. So I am giving the example most of the time earthquake, because earthquake can really very much I should not cross the river during this rainy season. I should be careful. That kind of belief will be of a person who are living in the flood zone area. But if I'm from Kathmandu, I will be not that fearful. I will be feeling that, okay, people will be daring also. I can cross that river. I can. There will be no accident. There will be no anything. So their belief and perception are different. So it is very challenging for the government to make people understand that how we can communicate and how can we make people aware about the risk. So there is very challenging situation. So that's why it was very important to understand the risk perception and how government decide and how government make a program to reach out to the people. Okay, and this topic was all about risk perception and decision making. So, I'm only coming to this topic. So, and the second most important is still there, which we'll cover by Bhavna. How can we communicate using the effective tools? Not only the tools, but effective tools. How can we can use the media? How we can use the awareness program and education to reach out to the people? Like there are different kinds of people. How we reach? Then this part will be covered by my friend Bhavna Guru. So I welcome you.